Hi everyone, my name is Mahesh. From this video, I'm going to start a series on Selenium and I'll cover all the topics in Selenium. If you're a beginner, I suggest to go through the videos in sequence of this playlist. So let's get started with Selenium introduction. What is Selenium? Selenium is a set of tools and libraries to automate web-based applications. So Selenium is not a single tool. It's a library. It's a set of libraries which are used to automate the web-based applications. So we know library is a collection of packages and classes, right? So Selenium is such library which is used to automate web-based applications. So web-based applications are the applications which we access through the browsers by providing the specific URL in the address bar, right? So those are called as web-based applications. So Selenium is a set of tools and libraries which are used to automate the web-based applications. And Selenium can also be used to automate some admin tasks which are web-based. Selenium is open source, right? So it's free of cost. Anyone can download Selenium and can start writing the scripts using Selenium. So you don't need to buy any license for using Selenium. It's completely free. Now let's discuss about Selenium components. We have three different types of components: Selenium, Selenium IDE, Selenium WebDriver, and Selenium Grid. Now let's understand what Selenium IDE is. IDE is Integrated Development Environment. So Selenium IDE is a standalone application which can be used to record the interactions on the browser, and we can actually playback those interactions once we are done with the recording. So this Selenium IDE comes as an add-on. So it was available for the Firefox browser, and now it's available as an add-on for Chrome and Microsoft Edge browsers as well. And the next component is Selenium WebDriver, very important component. So it's an API. WebDriver is an API which is used to send commands directly to the browser. WebDriver is used to create robust and regression automation suites for the web browser or web-based applications. And it's a very important component. We are going to actually use the WebDriver to write the Selenium scripts from the next video. And the last component is Selenium Grid, another powerful component which is used to run tests in parallel across different machines. When I say different machines, the machines can have different platforms and we can run on different browsers as well. So at the same time, we are going to run the same script on different machines and multiple browsers. So thereby reducing the execution time. So that is about components, Selenium components. Now let's understand what are the advantages of using Selenium. So Selenium supports multiple browsers. It supports Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Internet Explorer, Microsoft Edge, Safari, and Opera. Another advantage of Selenium is it supports multiple operating systems as well. Supports Windows, macOS, and Linux operating systems. And Selenium supports multiple programming languages as well. So it supports Java, Python, C#, Ruby, and JavaScript. Other advantages of Selenium is it's an open source, so you don't need to pay any license for using it. And we have a huge community out there. So once we start using Selenium, if you're actually facing or if you have some issues, right, writing the script, then there's a huge community, so you can easily get help from them. Selenium is easy to learn and use. So you don't need it's not like confined to a single programming language, right? As we have seen, so it supports multiple programming languages. So once you learn any one of those programming languages, then you can easily start learning and you can directly write the Selenium scripts. So it's very easy to learn and use Selenium. So these are the different advantages of Selenium. So in this video, We learned what Selenium is, what are the different components of Selenium, and what are the different advantages of using Selenium. And in the next video, we'll start setting up the environment, and we are going to write the first Selenium script. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.